fired from his day job in 2022 after he made racist statements about black teachers. We've got Lucas Scanlon, who forgets that he serves all of CFISD and not just his friends, and who during rezoning tried really hard to get some apartments rezoned out of his child's elementary school because those children don't, quote, go to the same parties or have the same amenities as his child. We've got Julie Heineman, who has been serving CFISD steadfastly for years and is currently our lone voice of reason and sanity on the board. We've got Todd LeCompte, who has worked hard to ban books and who believes the Bible should replace our student code of conduct. We've got Christine Kalmbach, who stated in writing that she supports vouchers and wants to abolish property taxes, which, if you paid attention at last month's meeting, you know funds a hefty portion of our public school budget. And finally, we've got Justin Ray, whom I believe sees CFISD Board of Trustees as nothing more than a stepping stone in his much grander political aspirations. If you've gotten a totally slimy vibe from him thus far, you're not wrong. Let's dig a little deeper into Mr. Ray's previous history as a business owner. He formerly owned a business which sold oil field equipment, some of which was knowingly improperly modified. He sold some of that faulty equipment to Lone Star Pipeline, and spoiler alert, the equipment failed. Mr. Ray didn't disclose that the equipment was improperly modified until Lone Star Pipeline asked about it, and even then he didn't disclose to the full extent until they sued him. Then, to avoid over $700,000 in claims, he filed for bankruptcy, but he somehow still managed to pay himself and his father $100,000 in the process. In 2020, the Secretary of State revoked his business charter because he's unethical. Don't let these people fool you. They're not here to ensure true opportunity for all CFISD students.